U.S. President Joe Biden warns Hurricane Ian may end up being Florida's deadliest storm ever. Ian left a trail of devastation across the state as the monster storm sent surges of ocean water into homes and businesses and cut off coastal communities. Biden says, though the numbers are still unclear, they are hearing reports of what may be substantial loss of life. He also praised Florida's emergency services as he described the scale of the task facing them as they enter zones devastated by the storm.
We're continuing to see deadly rainfall, catastrophic storm surges, roads and homes flooded. We're seeing millions of people without power and thousands hunkered down in schools and community centers. First thing this morning is when I talked to Governor DeSantis and again offered the fullest federal support. Earlier this week, I approved his request for the pre-landfall emergency declaration to provide direct federal assistance to the state for emergency protective measures to save lives, including search and rescue and shelter and food. My message to the people of Florida and to the country is, at times like this, America comes together. We're going to pull together as one team, as one America.
Biden says he will visit Florida once conditions permit. The U.S. National Hurricane Center says Ian has returned to hurricane strength and is on track to hit South Carolina on Friday.
The death toll due to Typhoon Kadapi rises to 11. The latest casualty from Antipolo reportedly died due to drowning. Six remain missing, while more than 25,000 people are still staying in evacuation centers. Social Welfare Department says distribution of relief assistance is ongoing, with the total amount of provided aid now reaching 29 million pesos. As for the estimated amount of damage to agriculture, it has already breached 2 million pesos.
Maaaring magkaroon ng pagtaas, lalong-lalo na sa alay at gulay, sapagat ito'y hindi tinamaan sa Central Luzon. Kaya at maaaring tumas ng mga 15 to 20% ang ating presyo sa kalakalan, ng kalakalan sa palengke.
Several establishments in Quezon Province have resumed operations days after being pounded by Carding. These include schools, wet markets, as well as the port of Polillo. But sea trips have yet to return to normal. Officials in the municipality of Panukulan hope for a quick rehabilitation of its port damaged by Carding.
Sa PPA, na mabilis sana makababa yung kanilang tao para ma-validate po yung naging sira dito. So ang challenge po namin, noong nagdadala po kami ng goods papunta dito, mga bangka lang po na hindi ganun kalaki. So ang hirap po na ilang beses na bibiyahe, may kalayuan po itong Panukulan.
The Philippines logs 2,536 new COVID cases on Thursday. Nearly half of them are in Metro Manila, where infections have been on the rise in recent days. The health department says almost all areas in the capital region are now at moderate risk for COVID, except for Caloocan, Malabon, Navotas, and Valenzuela. Health officials are also closely monitoring Pasig, Muntinlupa, Malabon, Makati, Navotas, and Caloocan, after noting an increase in the hospital occupancy rates of those cities. Despite this, the country's top health official believes there is still no need to resume the mandatory use of face masks in outdoor spaces.
Atin na pong tinitignan yung mga pasyenteng naka-admit kung maaari nating ilipat sa ating isolation facilities yung may mga mild at asymptomatic. Binigyan po natin sila ng option kung saan nila pwedeng ilipat para hindi na makadagdag doon sa naka-admit sa ospital at makapag-accommodate pa tayo ng mas maraming pasyente.
The Philippines lacks around 100,000 nurses amid the migration of health workers searching for better opportunities abroad. That's according to the Department of Health Officer in Charge, Maria Rosario Verajere. But that's not all. Verajere also says the Philippines is also now having a shortage of doctors, pharmacists, medical technologists, and other health specialists. Verajere hopes the country would retain the 7,000 annual deployment cap of new hire medical professionals abroad to address the problem.
Marami tayong shortage ngayon hindi lamang yung sa sinasabi sa mga nurses. We also have doctors na shortage na dati pa natin nararamdaman yan, especially in far-flung areas. We have a shortage or a gap of around 106,000 para mapunuan natin yung mga facilities natin all over the country, both public and private. Hanggang sa kulang pa po ang produksyon ng ating bansa sa mga specific healthcare workers professions na ito, sana po yung deployment cap natin ay manatili na lamang sa ganun.